Good. Good. We're teaching together a here and a now. And when I came in there at that moment, it was to recognize within myself the idea that the magnitude of bright light which constituted my reality was why I decided to assume this role. What I'm trying to represent, since you want a representation of me, is the totality of dedication to a single commitment. And to that, I intend to be faithful. Now, we're going to spend, I should warn you in advance, this has virtually nothing to do with the reality that you have superimposed in the idea of a reflection of light. Now, we're going to be using particular words, perhaps, like miracle. Very simply because the entirety of the beginning sequence was to indicate to you that the place and time in which you find yourself, right, is not actually there at all. Now, here's what disturbs you. The idea, there it was a reflection of light in which I am offering you another solution without a necessity to define the manner in which you are looking at me as I look at you. Now, if I do, which I'm obviously doing momentarily for you, I will assume a role, all right, in which the correspondence of the history of me, to make a difference how long the history is, it has to do, in this case, it has to do with the United States Marine. It has to do with the remembrance that I have concerning a dedication. This could be anything, dear one. This is a human being. It's a dedication to a solution to what appears to be a problem, and we all suffer from it. And we're all reasonably successful at overcoming the inherent conflict that we feel within our own mind in our efforts to recognize the joy and love that we hope to find. Is this true? Now, there isn't any secret to it when I came in here, because I brought, and I'm going to show it once more to you. This is a beautiful book, and yes, you can get it, and yes, it's been around for almost 800 years. All right. But all it really is going to offer you is the idea of a dedication you and I have arrived at in my solution to the problem of understanding who I am, what I am, and why I am. Now, the simple truth of the matter obviously would have to be, and I'm in a presumption here of looking out as you are as a Homo sapien when you came in here, and admitting that within the space-time episode that I'm in, I'm getting a reflection of light, all right, that is a provision for how I want to see myself in a correspondence with the energy that constitutes the universe. Can you say to me, universe?
Universe.
No, all I'm trying to do with you is get you to an admission that contained within the concept of yourself is considerably more than you are at this moment able to receive. Now, the entire manner in which that comes about, I very simply have to occur within the formulation of your body identity of yourself. Now, you want to challenge me as a 17-year-old Marine? Are you ready for this? I am a 17-year-old Marine. What you have to remember is that you begin to get recognitions of yourself. The history of you as Homo sapien has absolutely no concern about what you're seeing out in the world, with the total recognition that in the concept of yourself, you put it there. Now, okay, everybody now is finally settling down a little bit, and they're saying, well, it looks like he's going to give us another drama of an intention to undergo an experience that transcends the necessity for commitment. But you listen to that. The recognition that the commitment to what I desired was necessary is a nature of space-time. Very simply, if the cause and the effect are actually simultaneous, that is, everything that's being caused, this is what they attempt to do in the magazine, where I was going to try to show you that the energy that we're seeing here, that I'm seeing with my concept, really doesn't make any difference what my concepts are. You know why it doesn't make any difference? You obviously, when you begin to examine yourself, really don't know how you got into this dilemma. Now, this is a new series or an attempt following the success of a quantum idea in which obviously the dark energy that exposed you to pain and death and loneliness are no longer a part of you. And it's done with a memory. And it's done with the memory of you as a young man. And I'm going to sing, especially for you, the manner in which you escaped out into the universe.
Life is a book that we study. Some of its leaves bring a sigh. There it was written, my buddy.
I'm thinking of you.
That we must part, you and I.
So I'm here.
Nights are long since you went away. I think
it's as though each moment in the reflection of light, you understand perfectly well that it's changing. Come on.
Nobody quite so true.
What I'm introducing to you is a factor that's about 80 years ago. But it could be any distance between the reflection of light that you're getting in your body form.
Understand, my buddy. My buddy. Your buddy.